are students. Forever we are students. We keep learning from the birth to death. And no one above being taught by others. It doesn't matter, it doesn't matter who are the others. The others could be somebody on the main road, could be a cleaner, could be a porter, could be a professor, could be a wise man or woman, could be anybody. But you keep seeking knowledge all the time from people you meet, because they definitely have experience that you don't have. No matter what your degree is, what your experience is, it's unique for yourself. But somebody else's experience is unique also for himself. The wise man and the wise woman amongst us who seek knowledge. That's why the first verse in the Quran, or the first letter, or the first word is read. Read does not mean read and write. Read means that we seek knowledge. Seek the ability to understand, comprehend, analyze, and deliver. This is the meaning of the word read. Coming back to the domestic program, which could be very difficult, not only for you, but for any fundraiser who jump on a bandwagon of emergency response, which led people to cry, Syria, Myanmar, Afghanistan, Bangladesh, haha, people pay money. But you have to use your talent, your ability to fundraise for the more difficult, more sustainable for you and your organization and your aim and your cause and your mission and your message, which is a domestic program. If you are a farmer and you're given a salty land, it will take years from you to treat the land to get the trees to make it fruitful. If you go to the land which is near the river, very easy, the fruits will come very quickly. But you are not as good as the one who changed the soil to become fruitful soil or fertile soil. There's no shortage of fund, and this is something you have to put at the back of your mind. There's no shortage of volunteers. There's no shortage of needs and needy. You know where you find the shortage in? There's shortage in vision. People who have the vision. People who know the direction. People who have the innovative ideas. People who are messengers, because they believe in the message that they want to deliver. People that who are talented, and people that who can lead and become leaders. The shortage is in this side. But don't ever tell me that I cannot find fund. Fund is dead, but you cannot find it because I am blind. Because I am blind. I don't have the sight because I don't have a vision. I do the easy work. Give me money. Fine, finish. I want the challenge to be met by the challengers. I want the ideas and the needs of the people to be met by the talented. The people who believe that they can change desert to green, and they can remove the rocks and the mountains and pave the way for people to pass through to the second city, the second village. This is what we call humanitarian messenger. Humanitarian messenger, not worker. Worker is like a clock. You know this clock? Tick, tick, tick. When you tick me, I tick you. When you tickle me, I tickle you. Okay? But the messenger does not tick. He click, or she clicks, the community behind her or behind him. And I believe in each and every one of you who will be able to make the domestic projects here and there to be the jewel of your organization. Because domestic, you know what domestic project mean? Very solid ground that the community will stand on it. It's not a shaky ground that an earthquake will break it. This is the domestic problem, and how can we meet the needs of every individual? That's why I keep saying, a nation who does not have civil society organization cannot make a country, cannot make a state. It lives in a very fragile state. Could be very easily infiltrated by any group, handful of people, which change it from fragile into failing state. But the nation and the country or the state who understand and believe in building the social infrastructure of its people and this country and this nation and this state through a stronger civil society organization is very difficult to be penetrated by any group. And look around. How much European and American states are empowering their local services through local civil society organization, domestic programs, to complement the role of the government and the private sector. Very difficult, very difficult. Does not attract a lot of attention because there's no war, there's no conflict, there's no earthquake, there's no flood, there's no victims, but there's individuals. That means that you have to build the citizen, whether in Europe or in the field. When you go to the field, don't just keep feeding people, bringing water for them, or giving them their clothes, or building for them, but empower them, build their capacity, and teach them the know-how, which will lead them to stand on their feet to build the social infrastructure of their country. Domestic program here means domestic program there. Human resource development here and the human resource development there. Investing in citizens here and investing in citizens there. This is the name of our mission or of our message. And this is our mission, to build the individual citizen, male and female, young and old, from different background, different religion, different culture, different to everything. If you are able, as a messenger of humanity, you build humanity wherever you go. But if you are unable, as just a fundraiser, you become an opportunist and go beyond the news, but you cannot make the news. I want you to make the news, which can break the news, not just to use the news to catch money for your organization. I want you to be, what do you call it? Life makers, peacemakers, peace builders, okay? Peace brokers, not just people talking about something which they read from the book. We want each and every one of you to strengthen their back by bending it before the needy. The more you bend your back to the needy, the more that God will strengthen your back and raise your status and make you a legend in your life and in the life to come. If we don't bend our back, we cannot strengthen it. If we don't sweat, we cannot think properly. If we don't think, we'll sink with others. And this is the challenge. Don't just cry for Syria because Syria, but cry for building the society in Syria. Don't just cry for something, but build. Learn here how to build the society. So you can replicate it in Sudan, Bangladesh, Africa, Asia, Latin America. Stretch your hands to the people from your faith and people from other faith. Because humanitarian activity is beyond any and every society. Who amongst us here will help the children, the uneducated, the homeless, the sick, the people in hospital, which nobody can visit them, which cannot visit them, the elderly in the hospices, which nobody looks after them? Do we need to convert them to another religion? No. But we need them to love humanity. And when they look at you, they love you. And they see humanity in your action. Bend your back. I'm challenging you. Challenging you. Bending the back for others is the most difficult thing that you can do for your community, for your society, for your country, for your nation, for humanity. Don't come and tell me that domestic program or local program is difficult. You are weak. If you say that, that means that it's not difficult. I am weak. Because one boy or a girl, when she or he becomes a great leader, it will be one of your byproducts who can save the whole country. Okay? Because you are bending your back for such a miserably looking, sticky-eyed boy or a girl with running nose, with dirty clothes and bare feet. Does it have to be only in Bangladesh or Somalia? It could be here in UK. If you cannot succeed in a domestic program, that means that you are weak. I am challenging you. Meet me after 6 months and tell me what you do or what you did. Or meet me after a year. Or meet me after 2 years. And they will be challenging you. Because I love you. If I don't love you, I will never challenge you. The one who loves you, keep challenging you. The one who does not care about you, will ignore you. Alright? I love you. We love you too. That's it. Facebook me because she wants. She's the first that said she loves me. See, she loves me, huh? See me around. Jazakumullah khair. I love you. And I trust you. And I believe in each and every one of you. But you have to believe in yourself through believing in the community. Through believing ultimately in the Creator, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And it goes back. Because you are the messengers of the messenger of God, Allah, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and Isa Alayhi Salaam, and Musa Alayhi Salaam. Should be very proud of your fellowship and the fellowship of these great people. But Allah has sent them to serve humanity. They were not talking about humanitarian work, but they were talking about social work. Each messenger and prophet of Allah were social workers. Were social workers. Delivering the message to every citizen in the country and globally. Message of justice, fairness, democracy as they call it nowadays, equality, freedom, and free speeches. These are the messages of prophets. From Adam alayhi salam to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So please strengthen your back by bending it. Don't bend it to be broken by a chicken. You love chicken? Chicken and ships? Yeah. You love fish? Fish and chips? Katlim masamusa? Bakura? Okay. Jazakumullah khair. Alas, we see me around.